pay for them and ensure that the finance department have a deposit slip so that they register you. I'm seeing that nowadays the distance learning students, because they don't have to go to the finance, they are scanning the slip and sending it to the finance, and then the finance will act. I believe that everyone who has registered has an SPU email address, because that's the official mode of communication. You use your SPU email address and not any other. Now, if you book your units and found that maybe the unit you booked, you're not comfortable to sit for regular semester, you can always change. And now, since you have booked your units and gone to finance for registration, the first step will be to let the finance know that you want to make a change so that they register you. You are able to make the change by moving what you don't want to do and booking the new unit that you want to sit for. And then after you've made the changes, ensure that you register in with the finance so that the new changes are on your profile. All these policies are deadlines. So if you check on the academic calendar, there is that thing they call the deadline of add and drop. That's for making those changes. So ensure that you make those changes within that period of time so that you're not subject for it, making of changes. So when you finance register, after booking your units, this will enable you to be on a list of that particular class, and you'll be able to sit for CAS because already finance has registered you. You manage to sit for exams, you see the exam results online, and then you see financial statements online. So ensure that once you pay, and I know I know finance will let you know about this, once you pay, ensure that the finance department has access to that deposit that is able to register you, so that you are here or you are able to access all of it. Students like this, I believe that everyone who has registered, I'm sure for the Nairobi, the ones who have registered in Nairobi, they already have the student's ID. So ensure that you have that ID with you, especially when you are around and you want some services to be done for you, ensure you have the ID. Obviously, you'll be asked for the identity from the entrance. So ensure that whenever you are around and you want to access any of our campuses, you have your ID with you to gain access without any issues. You notice that your student number is your email address at sb.dc.ke, and also your number is the barcode on the student's ID, so you'll be able to receive services from the library using your ID, since the barcode is your number. So ensure that whenever you have your card, obviously services will be very easy for you to access. Credit transfers, these are when a credit enterprise from one degree program to another, and I believe that the heads of department will let you know about how to go about this. So credit transfer will be permitted up to a maximum of 49% of the total number of units you are supposed to sit for. So you apply to the head of department, especially those who are in other campuses apart from the MUDU. We normally don't have the faculty deans in the campuses. They are only based at them. That's the MUDU campus, our main campus. So with the other campuses, you apply to your head of department, and then after your head of department approves what is supposed to be awarded to you, you receive a letter confirming how many you've been awarded, and then you have to ensure that you pay for them. You are supposed to apply for everything now in your year one, semester one, everything that you want to be exempted, there you will buy 49%. So ensure that you apply for everything, because as a continuing student, they normally don't allow that. So you apply for everything, and by the end of semester, ensure that you have paid for all the charges for the transfers plus the total fee, so that you can sit for your exams. So all students here are based at one particular campus. Maybe you can transfer, maybe you're working in Mumu and you move to Machakos and you see that Machakos services will be nearer you, you can always transfer. So there are forms that are obtained at the registry. So you pick a form from the registry in the campus in which you are in, fill it in, you be clear, and then you take one copy to the registry of the campus you want to move for. So you'll be changed from the others you're currently into the new one that you want to move to, so that you can get in your services and sitting for your exams in the campus that you're comfortable with. Evaluation, students are expected to evaluate units they have done at a particular point. So this is why it's important to check on the dates. There will be a time when you'll be required to evaluate the units that you've done. This is just seeing how you have interacted with the unit, with the lecturer, and this will help enable us to improve in case there are any shortcomings. We'll be able to improve on that. And normally it's treated as a prerequisite for you to obtain an exam card. So it's important that you evaluate when that time comes. And also pre-booking of units. Towards the end of the semester, you'll be expected to pre-book the units that you want to sit for the foreign semester. So kindly ensure that when that time comes, if the distance learning office tells you it's ready for you to book the unit, ensure that you do that. Because sometimes it's also pegged to the seat of the student's ID, and if you haven't done, you delay yourself those people to come and to go and pre-book the units first. So kindly ensure that you check the dates. If the directorate is at that semester telling you to pre-book the unit, ensure that you do that at the right time. This one then was the department or the directorate to know how many units are doing a particular program or a particular unit in the following semester, and they're able to prepare in good time for that. Deferral of studies. Students are allowed to defer their studies because of many different reasons. The policy states that this should be done within the first 2 weeks of the semester. And so the process is that you write an email. Now you send your SPU email. Write an email to the director stating the reasons why you want to defer. And then the director will check on your issue and respond to you according to the duration that you requested for the defer. At this point, your profile will be deactivated. You will not be able to access your profile because it will be deactivated. Until that time, you request again to the director asking for the resumption of your studies. After you are approved for the resumption, then your profile will be activated and be able to access it once again. Now, you can continue deferring for as long as you want, but take into consideration that if you are a diploma student, from now, you are supposed to have finished your diploma in 3 years' time. If you exceed that, you will be discontinued. For the undergraduate, that's the bachelor's, a period of 6 years from now, you should have graduated, and the postgraduate, a period of 7 years. So, as you continue deferring, ensure that you take that into consideration, because if those years exceed, you will be discontinued, and if you want to come back again, you have to start again afresh from application. Unit road. Students are supposed to take a minimum. You can take a minimum of 3 units or a maximum of 5 or 6, depending on your program. So that's the maximum you can book. According to what your program approves, the maximum you cannot book more than the maximum. But after your first semester, because now you can only book the maximum, after your first semester, and your average is 70% and above, and you feel that you are comfortable taking more units, you can always add one extra unit. And through this, now you have to write to the head of department or the faculty dean requesting to add an extra unit. Now, when the approval is done, this one you have to book for you, because your program is set in such a way that you can't book more than the maximum. So you have to put that in renting, ensure that you got the even registry, so that when the approval is done, we just book for you. You just be observing communication. Communication just because that's why the director was saying you need not to come. As long as you write your emails, you write to the director, copy registry, the director approves, registry tells you what to do. If it's an actual registry supposed to do, like booking a unit, we just book for you and show you that you have booked your units are like this. So that what I is acceptable. If your average is 70% and above, and you feel comfortable to take more units, you can always add one extra. But ensure that you've done the prerequisite units first and passed before you can go to another unit. So important dates, they are available on the website. Actually, we have up to 2019 on the website. So ensure that you check them. And if you are around, can you pass into a notice board, check what is there. Sometimes you even send SMSs. And can you ensure that you check? Check important dates, because they have a lot of deadlines. And some of those deadlines may lead you to pay some more additional fee. So I do ensure that you check on that in good time. The examination process. So you shall be eligible to register for a university examination if you have registered for the semester, that is, you booked your units and paid for them within the deadlines, fulfilled all course requirements for the units booked, and participated in the coursework requirements. So ensure that when cards are sent, you do them and send them back in good time, and that you fulfill all the other course requirements as you have been told. So exam cards will be issued to each candidate who has fulfilled all those information. And in the examination room, we only require to have a writing pen, a student ID, and examination card, nothing else. Even your phone, even the mobile phone. Stop being found with a mobile phone on your desk, whether it's on or off, to be deemed as cheating. And cheating has very serious consequences. So, but if you are found in an examination room cheating, the consequences are that you'll be suspended for a whole semester, and marks will be notified for all the exams you have done. For example, you've done your first exams on Thursday, the second ones on Friday, and then on Saturday you are caught cheating. All the exams you have done will be notified, because we think you've been cheating throughout. So you'll be suspended the following semester. And after that suspension is over, and you have to go there, the letter that's normally given, they have four, you have to even pass through the cancer in order for it to be reinstated. So when you come back, you have to register afresh for the notified units, repeat the coursework again, pay full fees again, and take the exams again. So by the time you are coming back, now that will be in January 2018, you found that your colleagues are in their last semester. And you are starting all over again. You have wasted a lot of your resources, a lot of your time. So it's good to avoid that. Let's just be prepared for the exams. And trusting God will pass. So the examination results are always released online. And the only released results are the ones ratified by Senate. So if you receive your examination results, or the exam results are released, and you have a query, just ensure that you release that query within 2 weeks from the official date of release of the results. Because that's what we are saying, it's very good to check dates. What does this date state? I'm supposed to do this. Because you release a query after 2 weeks, it will not be attended to because you have already passed the time. So results are normally released and you are able to find them on your profile. We only issue hard copies of those results to those who request for them. So if you need a printout of your results, kindly request through the distance learning office, you receive that. And only results for the last three results are available. And now we can only issue results for the December exams, because the exams are done in April, the results are not yet out. So we are still issuing the December results. And once the April results are released, automatically the December course is done and we start issuing for the April. So you come and ask for results of a previous semester that we can't give, then that one will not be possible. The only option that we give is for a partial transcript. You can request for a partial transcript. And this one, since you're requesting it, because you didn't request for your results in good time, you normally charge a fee. If you request for a transcript before graduation, we charge a fee. At the moment it's 1,000. So you pay for that and you submit it to the directorate or to registry. We shall request for you from Limuru. We normally obtain such from Limuru. So we shall be able to request for any of that will be summoned for everything you've done, all we done together. Direct that to ensure that when you take your results, if there's a query with you having to seek an exam result by unit, direct your issue to the distance planning. On that email which you've been given and you've responded to. So exam results, they consist of coursework and examination. So ensure that you've done your class, ensure that you've done your assignments. Because if you don't do your assignments and you've done an exam, that one will be treated as a fail. Incomplete, it will be a fail. So coursework is very, very important. So when the coursework and the examination is processed at the department, then the department hands it over to the faculty board. When the faculty board ratifies it, it moves to the Dean's Committee, which is a subcommittee of the Senate, which verifies the results, then passes them on to Senate. Then Senate gives the final approval. As I said, the results released will be ratified by Senate, and then they'll be available.
Sorry for the interruption. If you have cups around you, please pass them to the back because the provider needs to leave. Thank you.
Thank you. So once the results are released, as I said earlier, you'll be able to view them on your profile, and in case you need a hard copy, you can request for that in good time. Now, the instances whereby you receive your results, either cards, assignments, and you're not satisfied, there's room for appeal. So when you want to appeal for a card, the first step is to discuss the matter with your lecturer. And if you're not satisfied with what the lecturer has told you, then you can write to the head of the department. If you're still not very satisfied, then there will be a supplemental committee that will meet and discuss your issue. If you're still not satisfied with what the committee has said, then you can put it directly to the faculty team, and then there will be a meeting. And after the final decision is made, no further appeals will be done. So be very sure when you are appealing. And then appealing against an exam result. This one should be made latest 2 weeks after official release of the exam results. So if you delay in checking your results, 2 weeks are over, you go check, you find there's an issue, and then you start now wanting to appeal, it will be too late, you'll not be able to appeal. So this one, now you write a letter, not an email, you write a letter to the Senate through the DBC academics, and then you pay at the moment each appeal, each unit is 1,000, so you pay, deposit money in the bank, attach the slip on the letter that you've done, drop that at any registry, maybe registry in your campus or with the director, with the distance learning directorate, and then your paper will be remarked, that's why you're paying, it will be remarked, and then after that, the grade you get will be the final one, there will be no more further appeal, so ensure that you are very sure again, because you might ask for a remark and get a lower grade. That will be final. There will be no further appeals. Repeat and receipt for exams. If you fail a unit here in St. Paul, you don't have supplementary exams, you don't have special exams, you book that unit again afresh. So if that you doing it, someone is shocked. You redo everything afresh. You put the unit before it to fit the requirements, do the cards and sit for the exam. And you can always, and after you pass, that grade will be rewarded with an R to show that you retook the unit. And you can only attempt 2 leases. So if you do a unit 3 times failing, policy says that you are discontinued. Even if it's your last semester, and you've done the units, you have done the unit 3 times and failed, you'll be discontinued, apply again afresh. Now the units you have passed will be transferred to the new number, and then you start again sitting for the unit. And no one of us will you have experienced that, and the first time you experienced that, it was even difficult to convince the student that we discontinued after prior to fresh. Look, that is for an exam. So you can be allowed not to sit for an exam. Policy has those three reasons, but stating that you are not able to do exams and stating the reasons, and where you can attach an evidence that maybe you are sick, attach a medical report on the email. So the director will approve your request, and you'll be told now what else to do. Now that coursework, the reason why we think coursework is very important. Coursework, if you do it, it is okay. But you can use it for the next 3 semesters. You do your coursework and you fail to sit for the exams. That way you don't go back to class again. You can use the coursework up to May, August next year. So you can use the coursework up to May, August next year as you still continue with your studies. But after now, 3 semesters are over, then you have to book the units again and pay for them again. So ensure that once you defer your exams, the semester that you defer, the same semester the following year, the same, that will be the final time to use the coursework. And this time, you can be allowed to do only a maximum of 3 exams because you defer your exams for this semester, the semester you come and continue with your studies. So you have put 6 more units in the semester. So the maximum number of exams you can sit for are 9. You cannot do more than the maximum for the semester, plus 3 for the deferred exams, and then the other 3, you can do them in the following semester. So ensure that you notify the university once you fail to sit for exams, because sitting for exams is compulsory. Students are also allowed to improve their grades. So if you do a unit now, you get a grade, a low grade, you can be allowed to improve it. And this time, again, you book the unit again, pay for it, and fulfill all the requirements. And the grade you get will supersede the earlier one. So the earlier one will be removed, and then the one you get is what will appear on your transcript. But kindly note that you cannot repeat a past year unit when you are in your third or fourth year. Even this one, if 3 semesters are over, you cannot be allowed to upgrade your grades. So ensure that within 1 academic year, if you want to upgrade your grades, you book that unit and sit for it. Discontinuation. Now this one, if in your first semester you get 40% and below 40%, that's 39.9. 40 is the pass mark. So you get below 40. In your first semester, you'll be given a first academic warning. That will be, let's say you are taking 6, the average of the 6. In your next semester, the average of the 12, now will be 12. The average of the 12 is below 40, you'll be given a second academic warning. In your last semester, the average of the 18 is again below 40, you'll be given an academic discontinuation. So when you are discontinued again, you have to apply afresh, you obtain a new number, and you come in now as a new student. And the units that you had 50% and above in the previous number will be transferred to the new number. You pay for them as credit transfers, and they are brought to your new number, and then you compete with the others. And that one you pay 20% of the unit cost of each credit transfer. So, as student allowed, we have registry Nairobi campus and we have registry mission center. Registry Nairobi campus caters for everyone else apart from BBA, BCom, and MBA. So, if you don't fall within BBA, BCom, or MBA, kindly when writing, just copy any of those registries depending with your program. Because now, for example, you ask for a deferred exam or third of semester, and the director approves, obviously she will respond to everyone in public. And now the registrar will see, here I'm supposed to do this, we just act. So can you ensure that you just copy us, even if you are not involved, we can try to see whether they have been responded to, and maybe contact those who are supposed to respond to. But mostly, we have something to do, and we do it, and let you know that we've done, we've acted. On email, we are very good for that, so don't worry. We shall respond to them as fast as we can. And you'll be notified on what to believe. It's booking a unit, we book and we show you these are the units we booked and everything else. And with that, I believe that we shall be able to get your vision, attain your vision, and one day we shall come and celebrate with you as you graduate. Thank you very much.
Let's appreciate her nicely. Okay, thank you, Madam Winnie. She's asking maybe just one or two questions, in case you're not clear.
Any questions? Okay, but currently, even though I know we are moving to a new system, currently exam cards are issued at the department. So after you've paid your fees, financial money provides a list of those who have cleared. So you get your name there, you go to a particular department, you actually give your exam card. So that's what it means. Even though I know with time you change to the new system, I think the new system you have to offer. So ensure that you clear your fee. If you have cleared your fee after the finance have posted the list, then they normally give a note. That note you put it to the department, you should do the exam. Now when you get to the program briefing with the head of the department, they'll let you know how long it will take. Yes. They said, each program, okay, you can do a minimum of 3 and a maximum of 6. Minimum of 3, maximum of 6. Credit transfers are charged 3,000 per unit. 3,000 per unit transfer. So you have to ensure that even if you get the 49%, you clear the whole amount and also clear T for the semester, not to proceed for the exam. Thank you.
There's someone here asking, what exactly does credit transfer entail, and does it apply to sitting of exams?
Credit transfer is anything that you've done before joining the board, and you want it transferred. It means that one will not attend any class for it. Those credits will be transferred to your number, so there will be no sitting of exams. But as the registry receives those exemptions, we feed them in your profile, and you start seeing them in your profile as if you've done them. Yes. So they will add up on your transcript.
Can that be duration?
Yes, of course. When you get transfers, you'll be here for a shorter time. Yes.
Okay, thank you. I think you'll be getting more information